Hello everyone, and welcome to this Miradore webinar on Android Enterprise Work Managed Device Mode in Miradore Online. My name is Sean Brennan, and I'm a marketing specialist here in Miradore. And let's have a look at the agenda. First, our technical consultants and key account manager for Germany, Austria, and Switzerland, Mr. Andreas Handler, will run through a demonstration in a pre-recorded video, and more about that shortly. And then we'll have a Q&A session with Andreas to answer all your questions. So we encourage you to type your questions in the question box during the demonstration, and then some closing remarks. So just a bit more about the pre-recorded demo. Andreas is going to run through an overview of device owner modes for Android Enterprise, and this will include how to set up the Miradore Online client as device owner, creating a managed Google Accounts work profile, and deploying applications to device and extract key information needed for the device. Now, in order to follow along easier and save time, you should know that Andreas has done some preparations before recording the demo. This is including enrolling the managed Google Play Enterprise accounts, preparing the user with the mail credentials, preparing the apps from the Play Store and configuring them, and creating a business policy to those to deploy those to one or more devices. So now we will begin the demonstration.
Thanks, Sean, and hello out there. As Sean mentioned, today I want to show you how you use Android for Enterprise with the device owner mode. As you can see here, I have here a new phone, and here you can see my helper phone. I use the helper phone to enroll my device. So, first we have to go to infrastructure diagram and activate the Android for Enterprise feature in Miradore. Therefore, you go down to the managed Google Play services, and I activated them before. To start working with managed devices, you have to go to Work Managed Device Provisioning and click here. Because enrolling these devices is very easy, therefore we use an app, the Miradore NFC app, and with this NFC app are credentials from a Wi-Fi, and the name of the Wi-Fi is sent to this new phone, and also if encryption is required, and if we want to keep the system apps. I already generated a QR code because I don't want to share my Wi-Fi name and password to the audience. So I have here my QR code. I take my helper phone now. I select Android 6 because this is the target system. I scan the QR code, I pump those phones together, I push the screen, and now you can see there is a request on the screen of my device I want to enroll. I say okay, and now the device tries to connect to the Wi-Fi. As you can see now, it's already connected. The admin app is installed. In our case, the admin app is the Miradore client. So we wait until the Miradore client is downloaded to this device, because then we are able to manage the device. You can see also the text, the device owner is set up now. I have to select my language. In this case, for this presentation, I select English, United States. You see, the client is already connected. I try to sync, and hopefully, oh, I get information that I should check the battery. If it's mounted correctly. And I hope that when the synchronization is successful, I can see this device already in Miradore Online. So, the device is successfully set up. I refresh here on the left, and I hope that I can see this device soon in Miradore Online. Here on the phone, because I selected remove all apps, just keep the important system apps, you see I have just the Miradore client on this device that is connected and syncing. Okay, synchronization failed this time because of a weak Wi-Fi, but now it's connected. It's still syncing. And I hope it appears soon in my web interface. And here it is. It asks for some permissions. I agree. And the device is successfully enrolled. But what can I do with the device owner mode? Therefore, I ask you to wait for a second because I want to install a better screen sharing app on this new device. So please be patient. So, thanks for your patience. Here you also can see the screen of the phone. The same at the bottom and at the top. What I have first to do is to open up the device in Miradore Online and select the user for this device. In my case, it's my own account. And I say save. And now I found a user for this device. So if you go back to the devices, you can see now a user assigned. And this user has also some additional information. If I open up the user here, there is a phone number, but there are also, so I entered here my email address, the domain, and the username, add the user, and what I did already before, I downloaded some applications from the App Store. On this device, I want to enroll the Adobe Reader app and the Task and Notes app for Microsoft Exchange. Therefore, I created a business policy where I enroll these two apps. So, to activate the Android for Enterprise, I go to the Device tab. I select my device and say Create Managed Google Account Work Profile. I say create, and if you take a look at the device, there is an information, and now the Google Enterprise account for this device is created. I close this window now because then the performance of the creation increases. At the device you can see something is downloading. These are the Google Managed Play Services, because if you have an Android for Enterprise account, they are automatically updated. So we wait now until these updates are finished and the Android for Enterprise account is created. So as we can see now, this process is finished. And the client is connected again. We can go to the home screen and we have full control over our device with Miradore Online. So what we can do now? We can deploy apps with configurations. When I go to the application Task and Notes, you can see here that I already prepared a configuration for this application. I entered here a mail server in the configuration. This is the mail server from Office 365, and I also told this app that it should take the email address and the password from the user. So, when I want to enroll this app and the Adobe Reader app to my device, I go to the devices, select my device and say add tags, because I created the business policy that means that with the name default apps, and I say add. And if I go here to the client, I can see when it starts syncing, and when it starts syncing, those apps will be downloaded. You can see on the top the download already started. First, the Adobe Reader. Now the Adobe Reader is installing. In between on the left, I select the business policy to take a view on it. You see here, default apps, Adobe Reader, and tasks and notes. So the Adobe Reader was successfully installed. And now task and notes is installed. So if I go back to the home screen, I can see that those apps are installed, also with the shortcut on the home screen. So what happens when I select the app on the home screen? The app opens up. You can enter credentials, but I don't need to enter credentials because I entered the credentials already in Miradore Online and deployed it to the device. So if I go in here and if I select the settings, if I go to account management, you already can see my Miradore Online account in here, with all information I entered. So this works quite simple. This is perfect and very powerful and easy to use. And when it has done the synchronization the first time, you can see my tasks. So one task was to do a webinar. I say, okay, it's done. And I'm happy that all worked so well. I want to say thanks for your attention. And Sean, the stage is yours again.
All right, great. Thank you, Andreas, for that demo. And now we have the Q&A part of the session where Andreas can answer any questions that you may have. So one question actually is it possible with this device owner mode to prevent sending SMSs?
Yeah, that's a funny question. Yes, this is possible, and this could also help to save money if you have to pay for SMS, and you can use messages service instead of this. So yes, you could prevent it. It's a configuration profile.
Okay. And another question is it possible to use this with an Android version 6 device?
Yeah, Sean, thanks for the question. Basically, it works from Android 5 with Google certified phones. That means when Play services are on the phone, if you take the phone out of the box, this should work. I found one device where it was not working with Android 5, but I've never seen a device with Google Play services on it where this Android for Enterprise feature was not working. So with Android 6, it should basically work.
Okay. Another question we have here. Is it possible with this device owner mode to prevent a factory reset?
Thanks. That's a good question. And yes, this is possible. You are the owner of the device if you enroll the device this way, and then you can create the configuration profile where you say a factory reset is not allowed, and then the factory reset can't be done on the phone.
Okay. Oh, great. And another question is it possible to prevent configuring tethering?
Oh yes, this is also possible, and some of my customers also use this because they have special data plans for notebooks and so on, and they don't want to have the employees using their phone with a different data fee for tethering their notebooks, so they disabled the configuration and also help to save money.
Okay, great. Oh, and we have a another question here. How can you assign users automatically to the devices you add with the manage device
product? You can assign a user automatically by entering the EMI of the device identifier at the user. Maybe if you switch the screen back to my computer,
sure,
I can show you where you enter it. So here you see one of my Miradore sites, and I go here to users, and I open up here. My user, and here you can see I have no device in here, and I can say add device identifier, and if I add here the EMI of the device, then the device is automatically assigned to the user if it appears in Miradore Online under the devices. I hope that answers the question.
Okay, great, perfect. Thank you for that, Andreas.
You're welcome.
I see that we don't have any further questions, so we'll go to the closing. So, to everyone, thanks for attending. We'll have a transcript of the Q&A session sent out to you soon for those of you who have attended, with a link to the video recording of the webinar. So thank you, and have a great rest of your week.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye.